ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो वंश ऋषभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरहित प्रज्ञान घन प्रत्यगर्थो ब्रह्माहमस्मि सोहमस्मि ब्रह्माहमस्मि। ओम प्रपन्न पारिजाताय तोत्र वेत्रैकपाणये ज्ञान मुद्राय कृष्णाय గీతామృతదుఖే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బిస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పరిపూర్ణ లక్ష్మీ కటాక్షం టు యూ అండ్ యువర్ ఎంటైర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ భగవద్గీత వర్స్ నంబర్ 18 ఆఫ్ 6th chapter. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Yada Viniyatam Chittam Atmanyeva Vatishthate Nisprahas Sarva Kamebhyaha Yukta Yityuchate Tadam. Bhagavan Krishna has completed Antaranga and Bahiranga Sadhanani from verse number 1 to 17. Now he is beginning to the subject which is the main subject of 6th chapter called Dhyana Swarupam and Dhyana Phalam, the nature of meditation and the result or fruit of meditation. Now we began from the last session in order to understand the language of Patanjali. So Patanjali has created a method that is a very useful and simplest method in order to understand and assimilate about meditation. We saw Patanjali has divided as eightfold way, we call it eight limbs, Ashtanga Yoga. The first five which we saw, Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara. Then now Dharana, Dhyanam, Samadhi. In the beginning itself I explained what the Patanjali, how he has developed his chapter. I think at the end of the 5th chapter, before beginning the 6th chapter, I spoke there are 4 chapters done by Patanjali. In the first chapter, he talks about what is Samadhi. He called that Samadhi is Yogaschittavritti Nirodhaha. The cessation of all the thoughts, vrittis, are called samadhi. He says the means are 8 limbs. Now the 5 limbs have been kept as a second chapter called sadhana padaha. Then third chapter which deals about dharana, dhyanam, samadhi is called vibhuti padaha. Then there is a kaivalya pada. Again he brings the topic of samadhi. In order to correlate with Vedanta, he tries. But one thing I have to tell here, we accept the method of Patanjali for the meditation, but we don't accept, means Vedanta don't accept, means Vedanta doesn't accept the philosophy, tattva, which is drawn by Patanjali. It seems to be inadequate in order to set the proper connection with the cosmos, means collective consciousness. We call it Brahman. But the process and everything we accept, even tattva also accept, we call it, it needs more to be explained. Now here we are adopting, even Bhagavan Krishna has told, the Krishna's language is little bit high in standard. It's not easy to understand because in one shloka he has given everything. Now we have the duty to explain and understand it. Now what is dharana? The first step for the meditation. In order to understand what is dharana, we should understand the nature of the mind. Even Krishna was asked by Arjuna, Chanchalam hi manah Krishna pramathi balavadridham tasyaham nigraham manye vayor eva sudushkaram. Arjuna asked, it seems to be very difficult to control the mind because mind is always fluctuating. Chanchalam he confirms. So the mind is fluctuated alone. And even Krishna also accept, yes, asamshayam hi mahabaho mano durnigraham chalam abhyasa yogena kaunteya vairagyena cha grihyate. If you have practice which is prescribed by Patanjali or Krishna, and vairagyena which is prescribed by Vedanta, you can control, you can come into a proper way, a route for spirituality. That is what we are now learning. What is the nature of mind? The nature of the mind is to jump one object to another object. Now, what is healthy mind means? The healthy mind should not be with one object. It has to keep jumping to object to object. No wrong in it. A healthy mind, if you see a young child, he should jump here and there. If it happens to see him is sitting in one place, something wrong with him, you should go and ask something, what went wrong. Now, as age grows, our mind becomes a little bit less restless. We become focused. But you know, when mind works a fast way, it becomes so fluctuated, it cannot make or it cannot be focused in one place. Now the mind, the nature of the mind is to go along with the object. But Patanjali says, no. Object is outside. Mind, when it sees any object, it converts all the object into vritti form. Vritti means thought. Long back, which I explained well, if you recollect that, it would be useful for us now. When you go in front of a tree, you will get the thought of tree. When you get the fruit of that tree, you will get the thought of fruit. Now the tree is an object which is created as the thought. Now at present you are having tree thought. If you go to next thought, you have to see the next object, then you can get the next thought. Now the tree thought has been replaced by fruit thought. Now fruit thought also can be replaced by another some thought. Like this, our mind is replaced by so many thought. Not only that, all the thoughts are even stored in our memory. Now, those memory will also sometimes pop out. It will also get re-vritti, again rethought. That's what the mind is. Our focus, it jumps to one vritti to another vritti, means one object to another object. The tendency of the mind is to keep jumping from one thought to another thought. Now we have to understand, like we understood body is endowed with karma, mind also is endowed with karma. And mind is very choosy. It always likes to stick with the very effective thought. Sometimes we become addicted to that. Again and again, why people smoke? Why people eat too much? Because they become addicted to that thought. They are not able to come out of it. Now that kind of mind which is fluctuated should be brought to dharana. Dharana means concentrate. Patanjali says, desa bandha chittasya dharana. Fixing mind in one place, means with one thought, is called dharana. Now, is there in our hand? Because when you keep your eyes open, When object are keep on changing, your vritti will also keep on changing, because the vritti is generated by some force. You are not willingly generating the thoughts. They are generated themselves. When you go and stand in front of a dog, you will get the dog thought. A vritti, the dog akara vritti, vrikshakara vritti. That is the tendency, the nature of the mind. Mind is like a mirror. When you show something, it will be reflected. So after showing something, you cannot deny, you cannot request the mirror to not reflect. Like that, you cannot request in your mind or to your mind. So don't get the thought, don't generate the thought which I am going to show in front of you. It won't listen to you. Because the nature of the mind, when something comes in front of it, it will create the thought. That is what the nature of the mind. Now if you want to control with one thought, again it's very difficult job. Dharana means fixing with one thought, means staying with one object. How it is possible? Therefore, our forefathers, they created the language. There is a sajatiya vritti, vijatiya vritti. The thoughts are two kinds, they develop. But Vedanta divides in different way. But the sajatiya vritti, vijatiya vritti means, if you are sitting in front of the tree, first you can have the sajatiya vritti. You can have the, because you know, mind is having the jumping attitude. You can jump trunk to branch, branch to leaf, leaf to flower, flower to fruit, again trunk. And also you can go to root and you can go to the color. You are wandering within the tree alone. The thoughts belongs to the branches of the tree and the leaf of the tree, fruit of the tree, sajatiya vritti. Vijatiya means from tree to dog, dog to human, human to sky, it's a vijatiya vritti, different variety. First said the sajatiya vritti. Therefore, the best way, you take any god's form, for example Mahavishnu, just you can close the eyes, you can have his face, and you can go to his kiritam, you can also think about his shankara and chakra, and you can also think about his vakshasthala where Lakshmi resides, and also you can come to padas, again you go to face, to his eyes, again kiritam and his hearing. So all this making round, wandering with the same Mahavishnu. That collective thoughts but centered on one object is known as sajatiya vritti. First make the sajatiya vritti. When you are eligible to sit without movement, then make your mind to wander with one particular sajatiya vritti. Then you are bringing or shortening the territory of the mind, because mind was wandering too much diagram. Now you are making it very shortened diagram. So then it becomes easier. Now apne kabu mein, you can bring in the control of the mind. First practice that. That is the first step of dharana. Then the next step, you know, from vijatiya vritti to sajatiya vritti, sajatiya vritti to eka vritti. Then you try to slowly reduce the thought. Now I said, for you, when you take Mahavishnu or when you take a tree, trunk to leaf, leaf to branch, branch to fruit, fruit to flower. So many things are there. Just you convert, you reduce the jumping. First trunk to branches, branches to flower, flower to fruit, fruit to the color, color to root. Now just you change, you reduce it. Trunk to branch, branch to flower, flower to fruit, again trunk. Then trunk to branch, branch to flower, flower to again trunk, you reduce. Then you keep changing trunk to branch, branch to trunk. Then trunk. The trunk, the top of it, and the center of the center portion and the below portion, again you change, then your mind will get a kind of practice. Abhyasena tu kaunteya. So when you keep doing, but you should not lose your confidence. Therefore we spoke in the beginning itself that to self-confident is very important for our meditation, because it's a very difficult task. You know, you can conquer the enemy outside, doesn't matter how many numbers they are, but you know, getting victory over your mind is very challenging job. Now you should have a practice day by day, day by day, day by day, day by day, month by month, month by month. But your mind definitely will relate you, will help you. You can have the ability to bring in one place. So when it is sticking with one vritti known as dharana, so there we have to supply one more knowledge. So when you do this process, you are there, the selected object is there, then the effort is there with the instrument. Now you are called dhyata, the material Mahavishnu or tree, it will be known as dhyayam, and your eyes will be called karanam. Then the process is known as dharana. Okay, dhyanam, we call it dhyanam. So when there is an effort, your mind going out, coming back, and you are bringing back again and again. So in that cause, in that place, we call it, that process is known as dharana. Then when you are able to stick with one vritti for a long time, it's known as dhyanam. That is also to stick with only one vritti. But in the dhyanam, there is a difference, bhedaha. That bhedaha, dhyata, dhyanam, dhyayam, three difference are involved in the dhyanam. You are there, then the selected object is there, and the process of meditation also is there. That is the first step of dhyanam. Slowly, you know, you will become one with that vritti. That vritti. So, because when the selected object from outside, so you become Mahavishnu vritti, means you will disappear, only Mahavishnu will exist. Like when you listen to the music, you become one with the music. You lose yourself, you dissolve yourself, you get lost yourself. You cannot lose yourself. That identification, the individuality is dissolving into that, or merging into that object called meditation. Dhyanam, it has to take, we have to lose ourselves in the selected object. So when we merge with that object, we should have selected a proper object, because that object will penetrate in you. If you select proper music and becoming one with that, that all positive energy of that music will penetrate you. It will impact your body, mind and sense complex in positive way. If you would have selected wrong object for meditation, it will also penetrate in you with a wrong impact. This dhyanam is known as a valuable process. After, you know, when you become one with, even that object also dissolves where you are becoming one with. So dhyanam alone remains, is known as samadhi. Dhyanam, he actually Patanjali says, you know, tatra ekatanatha, pratyaya ekatanatha dhyanam. Tatra means whatever the object is selected, becoming one with that vritti is known as dhyanam. Then samadhi means only dhyanam remains. He says, తదేవార్థమాత్ర నిర్భాసం స్వరూపశూన్యమివ సమాధి. స్వరూపశూన్యం భవతి, యు లూజ్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్ అండ్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ ఆల్సో లూజెస్ ఇట్స్ టెండెన్సీ. ఓన్లీ మెడిటేషన్ ప్రాసెస్ ఎగ్జిస్ట్. ఆల్ దిస్ త్రీ టుగెదర్ ఆర్ కాల్డ్ సమాధి. దిస్ ఇస్ ద లాంగ్వేజ్ బై ఆర్ పతంజలి ఋషి. Now you should know the tendency of the mind, because vrittis, they come and go, come and go, come and go. But Vedanta beautifully divides in the beginning itself, you know. So when Patanjali says, your mind is nothing but the bundle of vritti, so vrittis are too many, you cannot count, because mind has the tendency to change the vritti as much as possible, very fast. That is the nature of the vritti, but you should know how to segregate them. Vedanta says only there are two vrittis. Patanjali says there are five kinds of vrittis. But Vedanta says, no sir, only two vritti. Aham vritti, idam vritti. I thought, this thought. Vritti about me. Because in order to realize me, I convert my existence into a vritti. If I ask you, are you there? Yes, I am there. Are you there? Yes, I am there. How are you there? So I am there as I am. As I am means what? As a human being, there where you are caught. When you say, I am a human being, you have converted yourself into a thought. It's known as aham vritti. The vritti belongs to me. My body, my limbs, my thought. So all belongs to me. And I, me, myself. Aham vritti. Aham thought. Idam vritti means all remaining thoughts except the thought of me. If I say, I am is one thought. The world is a second thought. All thoughts come together. Finish. Vedanta is very solid. Bhagavan Krishna, he brings the same. When aham thought becomes central, idam thought will be valid. Without aham thought, idam thought means, you see, you should not get confused. See, when you get up early in the morning, both thoughts will arrive. Like, I am, the world is. I am, the material of the world are. I don't get that only I am, world is not there. In the beginning itself, I get both thoughts. The thought about me, the thought about the world. So whatever I experience, as I that endowed with two kinds of thoughts. If you drink the coffee, you have the two kinds of thought, the taste of the coffee, flavor of the coffee, and the material of the coffee. Whatever the ingredients are used for the coffee, everything you have as in the form of thought. At the same time, the person who drinks and enjoys, you should also have that as a vritti. And don't get scattered, okay? This is very easy to remember. In this world, in your whole life, you have two kinds of thoughts alone. So your thought, the thought about your I, a vritti about your I. If you remove this vritti, which is in the form of I, no thought will be valid. Now you sit for the meditation. Let any thought come. Let all the thoughts to take place. Never worry. I think about the past experience or event. You can focus on other material which you could see, you could you enjoyed with them. You could pay attention on that object, also you can focus on the experience you experienced, and also you can focus on the experiencer. But you should know how to practice. For example, now go and stand in front of some flower. Take a lotus, take a rose and stand in front of it and look at that and just focus on the rose with an understanding. So this is an object selected by me for my meditation. This is called dhyayam. Okay. Now the dhyayam is means what? I have vritti of you. You can even speak with that rose. So I have vritti of you. And that vritti is supported by the vritti who is me. So in order to say this is a rose, you need to have I. Therefore, every sentence it has got I. So without I thought, there is no thoughts are valid. So it becomes center. Now you can focus. You can keep your eyes on the rose. You can pay attention on the rose, or you can pay attention on the eyes. Even keeping eyes on the rose, though eyes on the rose, you can keep your attention on the your eyes, or you can also keep your attention keeping eyes on the rose, but the attention on you. Now you change or shift your attention to rose on eye and eyes. You can pay attention on the rose. You can also pay attention on your eyes, and you can also focus on you. That is Patanjali's method. The same method is followed wherever the meditation is taught. Now you are the selector. If you can focus only on the rose, means you are the beginner. When you focus on your eyes, you are little bit matured and grown in meditation. When you are able to center on you, you are able to focus on you, you become advanced meditator. It's the same thing can be done with your ears. Close your eyes, and because ear need not to open, it's kept open. Play some warm sound. When the sound is listened, means heard by you, Om, Om, Om. Though it is converted as the vritti, we have the two kinds of division. I vritti, then idam vritti. Now I can shift my contemplation called watch, focus or attention on the Om or on the ear or on me. So this is Deshabandha Chittasya Dharana. The process, again and again I focus on the Om, then I focus on the ear, then I focus on the eye. Then the next step, I lose, because you know the two kinds of meditation. Either you should lose yourself on the object, or that object should dissolve in you. That is the method. So meditation, which we call, this is the process of meditation. It may take long time for you to set with this. We will continue little bit more simplest way, but in elaborate way, in the forthcoming session, in the next episode tomorrow. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. Thank you.
now.